Hello student, I am P.Kumar of E-Age Education Center. We are going to discuss moment of inertia and its axis. First of all, we try to understand what is the moment of inertia. To understand the moment of inertia, if the mass is more, it is difficult to change its positions from one point to another point. In the same way, if the moment of inertia is more, it is more difficult to rotate about the given axis. It means that in the translatory motions, what the functions of the mass is the same functions of the rotational motion of moment of inertia. If we have to define the moment of inertia, then we can define how difficult to rotate a body about a given axis and measure its moment of inertia. The moment of inertia opposes the rotation's motions. If the more moment of inertia, more torque is required to rotate about its axis. So first of all, we try to understand if the mass is more, it is difficult to change its positions from one point to another point. In the same way, if the moment of inertia is more, it is more difficult to rotate about the given axis. It means that in the translatory motions, what the functions of the mass is the same functions of the rotational motion. This is perpendicular to the length of this. This is the circle. This is a circle and here is the center. And we see that it is rotating. This is the center. It is rotating. This is rotating about this axis. It may be rotated about the clockwise or anti-clockwise. It is rotated about the clockwise. This is the axis. And if we have to find the moment of inertia, if we see the moment of inertia of a rod about the one end, how can we decide? If we have to find the moment of inertia of a rod about the different axis, this is the rod. And if we have to find the moment of inertia about the axis which is passes through the one end and perpendicular to the length of this rod, here is the axis is passes through this. It means that will rotate, it will rotate in this way. It will rotate in this way about this axis. If I have to find the moment of inertia, if I have to find the moment of inertia of a ring, if this is the moment of inertia, this is the center and this is the diameter. It means it will rotate. It will rotate in this way. Moment of inertia that will rotate about this axis. If you have to find the moment of inertia of this circle about the tangent about its axis. Moment of inertia of a circular disk about an axis which is tangent. Moment of inertia of a circular disk. This is the circular disk and we have to find the moment of inertia. The axis must be given. If I am saying the moment of inertia of a cylinder, so what is the meaning of this? It is the meaningless. The moment of inertia of a cylinder, it has no meaning. Why? Since the axis is not given. The axis must be given. If I say the moment of inertia, this is the cylinder, this is the cylinder. And if I am saying the moment of inertia of this cylinder, what is the meaning of this? It has no meaning. Since the axis may be in this way, it is the passes or it will rotate in this way. This is the moment, this is the cylinder. The moment of inertia, this is the axis. The moment of inertia of the about its axis, it will rotate in this way. Different axes have the different moment of inertia. Understand? So the axis must be given. The moment of inertia of a ring about the axis which is perpendicular to the plane and passes through the center. That moment of inertia, this is equal to mr square of a circular disk. This is the circular disk. It will rotate about this axis. Again, we have to find the moment of inertia of a circular disk about an axis which is passes through the center and perpendicular to the plane of the ring, and the moment of inertia of circular disk. Moment of inertia of a circular disk, this is the circular disk, so we can say the moment of inertia of a circular disk about axis passes through the center and perpendicular to the plane of the disk is equal to mr square upon 2. Since the m is equal to mass of disk hollow cylinder about this axis, the moment of inertia, that is the same, the moment of inertia of the ring, this is equal to mr square. In the same way, the m is the mass, r is the radius, and the moment of inertia, this is the solid sphere, solid cylinder. This is the sphere. It is the hollow sphere. And the moment of inertia about its diameter, it will rotate about this axis. M is the mass of this sphere, mass of sphere. And this is the hollow sphere. Hollow sphere. M is the mass of the sphere and R is the radius. Then the moment of inertia is equal to what? Moment of inertia, this is equal to 2 by 3 sorry the moment of inertia of a solid sphere about this axis, it will be mi. This is the solid sphere. So this is equal to 2 by 5 mr square. This is the solid sphere. About its diameter, we can say the moment of inertia is 2 by 5 mr square. And this is the hollow sphere. The moment of inertia is equal to 2 by 3. It means that is the more moment of inertia of the hollow sphere compared to the moment of inertia of a solid sphere. Since the mass is distributed more at a more distance from the axis.